our every human limitation, and from the pure substance of your love, bring into manifestation this world according to your perfect law. And because we cooperate with that law and allow it to unfold in and as our lives, so it is. Please join me now in following in the teaching of our Master Jesus Christ and speak our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from error. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Get out of bed, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. Before I even lift my head, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. This is how I start the day, knowing good is on the way. I am claiming perfect health, love and laughter, friends and wealth. In the morning when I get out of bed, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. Before I even lift my head, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. With conviction undeterred and power of the spoken word, take my life and redefine, break the shackles of my mind. In the morning when I get out of bed, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. Before I even lift my head, I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I claim a blessing. I lift my thoughts to higher ground, knowing miracles are all around. Each day unfolds as it should when I'm focusing on the good. Each life is filled with opportunity. Wonder what good is coming to me. I claim a blessing. I claim it. I claim a blessing. I claim it. Ooh, I claim a blessing. I claim it. Ooh, I claim a blessing.
So are you ready? You claim a blessing this morning? Yes. Yes. By the way, I just want to mention to you that Ken's wearing a mask because what we know is that the viral load of singing is much greater than just speaking. So it's not because we love Ken less and we're making him wear a mask. We're asking everybody to do that except those of us that are speaking. This coming Thursday at 7 o'clock is our remembrance service, and this is an opportunity for those of you who have loved ones that have passed on that you would like to honor. You can provide their name to us today or tomorrow at the very, very latest, and we will read their name aloud as part of the service. So there'll be some special music. It's a candle lighting service. You can be here in person if you choose to do that, or you can participate from home on Facebook Live, just as you're doing this morning. I also want to remind you that our Thanksgiving picnic boxed lunch is still underway. The plan is to meet at Sunrise Park on Saturday at 1 o'clock. Yes, from 1 to 3. If you don't have a ticket and you want to attend, you must purchase a ticket today, no later than tomorrow afternoon, please. We have to get our order in. The people that have chosen to sign up are excited. So if you'd like to come and be a part of that, we would love to celebrate with you. We'll be honoring all of the social distancing guidelines, so just know that. Then our Thanksgiving Eve service is on Wednesday before Thanksgiving, the 25th, at 6 o'clock. This is a time, again, where we'll have special music, we'll have some speakers, some of our congregation and friends who feel especially blessed this past year. We'll ask them to share with you. It's a wonderful time for us to get very, very centered and connected with our own spirit of gratitude. It will set you up for the best Thanksgiving ever, even though we are still interacting with COVID and all of the things that means.
Be the love you are. Be the love you are. Just as Master Jesus taught us, be the love you are. Shine the light you bear. Shine the light you bear. Just as Master Jesus taught us, shine the light you bear. Sing the song you hear. Sing the song you hear. Just as Master Jesus taught us, sing the song you hear. Know the joy of life.
Know the joy of life.
Just as Master Jesus taught us, know the joy of life. Be the love you are. Be the love you are. Just as Master Jesus taught us, be the love you are. Just as Master Jesus taught us, be the love you are.
Be the love you are. Yes, it's true. Be the love you are. Join me now as we prepare for this time of prayer and meditation. So let's prepare our physical bodies first. And so we breathe. We breathe together. Let's take a deep breath in. And we release that breath. Let's just do that a few more times together. We exhale. And you take this time as you prepare just to set aside anything that's calling for your attention. Whether it's something in your physical world, so. My prayer is that you're in a quiet place now. Just watch your breath. just allow it to easily and effortlessly do its work for you. And so you settle in wherever you are, fully supported, wherever you're sitting. And we take another deep breath in together. And we release that breath. And as our bodies become still and supported, our thoughts do the same. We're just creating space. Just creating space. Just as our Master Jesus taught us, we come apart for a while. So we take another breath in together. And we release that breath. We notice a little more calm coming in right here, right now. Be the love you are, created in divine love. That is our truth. And so I ask you to take that inward for just a few moments. Created in divine love. Each one of us present here this morning, and everyone who is not present here in this physical situation as well. There is no separation between any of us. And perhaps this morning we can embrace that oneness even more. Perhaps allowing that to be our intention and our energy that we send out this day in this beautiful world that we live in. Let us breathe in. And we exhale. And so, friends, how are we showing up as that divine love? Are we treating ourselves with love this day? How's that self-talk going? So for this now moment, visualize with me, please. Allow that divine love just to pour over you, immersed in divine love. Breathe in with me. And exhale. Place your hands on your heart if you choose. With the power of divine love resides, place the physical location in the body. And as you immerse yourself in divine love, become a little more gentle with yourself, a little kinder with yourself, a little more accepting of yourself, a little more compassionate with yourself. Breathe in with me. Exhale. from this place. We be the love we are, just as Master Jesus taught us. And as we share and know that love for ourselves, we are then able to share that with others. And so I invite you now to visualize with me, who's easy for you to do that with? What person comes to your mind so easy to share that divine love with? And you smile. And you envision yourself giving them the biggest hug ever. And you go, ah, it's an ah feeling. Divine love, thank you. Thank you. And now I invite you to call forth someone that perhaps is not quite as easy. Not quite as easy. But nevertheless, divine love is our intention to share. And we allow the God, the divine within us, to do for us what perhaps we cannot do for ourselves in this moment. And we breathe that in. And we exhale. So as we move into the silence, I invite you to see yourself immersed in divine love. And I invite you to see that person that's so easy for you to love, immersed in that divine love. And I also invite you to see those that perhaps aren't quite as easy to be immersed in divine love as well. And as we move into the silence, we ask Spirit, have your perfect way with us now. We take another deep breath together and we release that breath. And as we come back to this place, this space, this time together this morning, we do so with a knowing that we have been created in divine love. Divine love is who we are. So we go forth this day to be the love you are. And so it is. Amen.
Everywhere I look, I see God in everything. Deep inside and all around me, God in everything. I could feel it in my beating heart, God in everything. It's in every breath of life I take, God in everything. Everywhere I look, I see God in everything. Deep inside and all around me, God in everything. It's in every stranger's face I see God in everything. Brothers, sisters, family are we, God in everything. Everywhere I look, I see God in everything. Deep inside and all around me, God in everything. Mountain, valley, lake and stream, God in everything. All creation, beautiful and free, God in everything. God in everything.
In the Gospel of John, chapter 13, verse 34, it's recorded that Jesus said, "I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another." One of the highest forms of loving one another is through friendship. Samuel Taylor Coleridge, in his poem, Youth and Age, described friendship as a sheltering tree. I like that image because it seems so warm and inviting to me. Unlike family and friends voluntarily come into our lives and provide a sheltering tree of love, respect, empathy, listening, and presence. A friend is someone who understands your past, believes in your future, and accepts you as you are today. Friends are precious gifts from the universe that make everything easier and more fun. Hopefully, family members are also friends, but it's not guaranteed. Some of us know that, don't we? And so we know these things about our friends, and we understand at a deep level that friendship is just necessary for us to have our best life. And yet somehow we can let it go to the background. So today I'm inviting all of us to be very present to the idea of giving thanks for friends, those dear souls who volunteered to share our journey. I was intrigued by the Webster Dictionary definition of friend, as oftentimes when I'm researching for a message, I will go to the dictionary and look up keywords. And so, not unlike any other time, I did that. And the definitions that I came up with were: one attached to another by affection or esteem, acquaintance, one that is not hostile, and a favored companion. Now, while technically all of those seem accurate to me, none of them actually provided a definition that seems to fully describe the depth of what friends are and how profoundly they influence our lives. In these definitions, there is no hint of the gift of friendship as described by John O'Donohue in his book Anamkara, where he writes, "A friend is a loved one who awakens your life in order to free the wild possibilities within you." Did you know that? What is the purpose of friends? They just come in and love you and awaken all the wild possibilities for your life. Well, I liked that too, because it seems so powerful as something that we can do for one another. We can receive that from others and we can give it to others. And that is, in truth, what Jesus did for each one of us. He saw the Christ potential in each of us and taught us how to live our lives from the place of spiritual empowerment. In a similar way, that's what we do for each other as friends. A friend is one who sees the potential of the Christ in you, though they may call it by another name. The potential to rise above all challenge, to successfully pursue your dreams, to build the relationships your heart most desires, and to be empowered and fulfilled. Friends remind us of our true nature as empowered spiritual beings, co-creators with God. They see how awesome we are. They praise and reassure us with honesty. So I'm not talking about flattery. I'm talking about sincere, heartfelt praise and just reassurance. The intimate connection between friends creates a field of safety and support in which both individuals can thrive and experience more fulfillment, joy, and abundance. Friendship gives us permission and unconditional support to be authentic, to be real, to show up the way we really are in any given moment, to follow our passions, to flourish, to fail, to be happy, and to be sad. Friends take us as we are, and they love us no matter how we are showing up. Now, that doesn't give us license to abuse other people in any way, but it does say, if you're having a bad day, your friends won't hold it against you forever. They might walk away and say, I hope you can get over this soon, but they never just leave you completely. Lawrence J. Peter said, you can always tell a real friend when you've made a fool of yourself. He doesn't feel you've done a permanent job. See, we all need friends who can see our weak spots and not capitalize on them or punish us for them. Friendship is a commitment to love and stand by our friend, even when it might be easier to do otherwise. We see a beautiful example of this in the Old Testament book of Ruth, which is the story of Ruth, who was a Moabite woman and whose mother-in-law was not, and she had moved with her family to her mother-in-law's land, and all of the men in the family, her husband and her sister-in-law's husband, the whole family had died, the men, during a time of real critical mass there. So Ruth was, needless to say, grieving for her husband. Naomi was grieving for her sons. Ruth's sister-in-law was grieving for her husband. But the law of the land was such that whenever a woman's husband died, if she was not a citizen of the land she was living in, it was better for her to go back to her homeland. Naomi knew this, and so she said to Ruth, listen, you need to go back to your homeland so that you'll be safe and things will be good for you. And Ruth answered her saying, do not press me to leave you or to turn back from following you. Where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. And so in more contemporary language, what she's saying is, I won't leave you. I am in, all the way in. I will stay by your side wherever you go, whatever happens. Your people have become my people, my tribe, and we all have the same God. Ruth's commitment to her friendship with Naomi was so deep that she could not be deterred from staying. and seeing Naomi through the challenges that she was facing. So her friendship, her love for Naomi allowed her to set aside her own personal need to stay and be of support to her mother-in-law. Henry J. Nouwen, in his book Out of Solitude, Three Meditations on the Christian Life, wrote, "When we honestly ask ourselves which person in our lives mean the most to us, we often find that it is those who, instead of giving advice, solutions, or cures, have chosen rather to share our pain and touch our wounds with a warm and tender hand. The friend who can be silent with us in a moment of despair or confusion, who can stay with us in an hour of grief and bereavement, who can tolerate not knowing, not curing, not healing, and face with us the reality of our powerlessness, that is a friend who cares." And I believe that Nouwen meant powerlessness in the sense of we don't always have control over the circumstances of our lives. And we need people that will be there with us when that's happening. See, friendship is an exchange of love that gives both individuals a chance to offer needed support and companionship. It is both giving and taking, which is a necessary component for sustaining the free flow of divine love, which is the answer, of course, to everything. So just being around friends can encourage us to do our best. When we spend time with those individuals who are spiritually grounded, have strong ethical values, are generous with their time, talent, and resources, those who give loving service to the world, are motivated, it inspires us to do the same. Just being in the presence of those individuals motivates us to step up higher in our own experience of life. Friends can help relieve stress for one another. As the song goes, we all need somebody to lean on. We all need somebody that can hold our hand, at least symbolically, as we meet certain challenges. And it doesn't have to be a giant challenge. Have you ever had a time in your life when you just needed to do something that was actually a small task, but for some unknown reason, it just seemed too overwhelming to do it by yourself? I have. And I used to scold myself about it and give myself the buck up talk and try to kind of force myself through it. Well, sometimes it worked and sometimes it didn't, which meant that I would be delayed in taking some needed action for a long period of time, perhaps. Then by grace, I discovered that I could actually let a friend help me. For example, this is mundane, but nevertheless, it was an event in my life, and you may be able to relate to similar things. I needed to purchase a new outdoor lamp post, and I just felt stuck trying to decide which one and where to buy it. And so I toyed around with it, you know, looking things up online and thinking about this and thinking about that. What color do you want? And blah, you know, just the circle that one can get into. And then my daughter-in-law was visiting and she looked at the lamppost and she went, "Carmen, you need a new light." And I said, "Yep, I know." And she said, "Well, why don't I just take you over to the hardware store and let's get one?" And I said, "You know, that would be great." I was very grateful since I had been mentally toying with that project for weeks. And then, in addition to that, she offered to have a friend help her install it the next weekend. Yes. Every time I look at that lamp, I feel a warm glow of being loved and feeling very grateful for the friendship that it represents. had she not offered to help me, I don't know how much longer I might have played with that. See, during this time of social distancing related to coronavirus, maintaining our friendships is more important than ever. Being unable to see friends and hug them in the way we usually would can lead us into not just social distancing, but social isolation. See, the effects of social distancing may begin with just feeling lonely and maybe a little more vulnerable than usual. But if those are not attended to, it can progress into social isolation, which is characterized by depression and addictive behaviors such as substance abuse. Friends, it is a gift to those that you consider to be your friends to reach out to them even more during this unusual time of stress. A phone call, text, or a note reminds others that we treasure their place in our life as a friend. Sometimes we just need a friend to listen. I can remember times after Al passed that I would suddenly have a wave of feeling a bit overwhelmed with grief. And there were those friends that I knew I could call and just say, you know, I'm really feeling kind of sad. I just needed to hear your voice. And that was enough. See, they didn't ask me to explain why I was still grieving. They didn't go into any of that. They just said, okay, tell me what's happening. And I'm so grateful for those individuals. Some of them are here in this room. You know who you are. And I so love the fact that you could listen and just be present. What a gift. Sometimes we need a friend to pray with us or to simply remind us God's got you. So you can do this. Yes, thank God for friends. If you feel lonely or stressed, call a friend. Your friend probably needs to hear your voice as much as you need to hear his or hers. You might also consider using Zoom or Facebook to connect with friends. See, the point is we need to connect however we can safely do it. We need to connect. Human beings are designed for connection. We don't do well without it. An Arabian proverb says, a friend is one to whom one may pour out all the contents of one's heart, chaff and grain together, knowing that the gentlest of hands will take and sift it, keep what is worth keeping, and with a breath of kindness, blow away the rest. Friends are always willing to look for the best in us and to gently help us find our hope, strength, and power. Yeah, thank God for friends. Albert Schweitzer said, sometimes our light goes out, but is blown into flame by another human being, a friend. Each of us owes deepest thanks to those who have rekindled this light. And I expect that all of us can look at our lives and realize that there are countless numbers of people who have at one time or another rekindled the flame for us. And we do thank them. According to the Mayo Clinic's website, having friends makes us healthier and increases our ability to thrive and be happy. They say friends are good for your health. Friends can help you celebrate good times and provide support during bad times. Friends can also increase your sense of belonging and purpose, boost your happiness and reduce your stress, help you cope with traumas such as divorce, serious illness, job loss, or the death of a loved one, encourage you to change or avoid unhealthy lifestyle habits such as excessive drinking or lack of exercise. I can tell you, I probably wouldn't exercise much at all, except that I have a walking buddy. And God bless her, she is a good friend, because she will show up even when she'd rather not, and I will show up for her when I'd rather not, you see, because we've made that commitment to do that together as friends. Studies have even found that older adults with a rich social life are likely to live longer than their peers with fewer connections. So having friends is literally a lifesaver and a life extender. So is wearing a face mask right now. It's a way, friends, that we can show our love for one another and be a friend to everyone. There is a prayer that was written by moderator Richard Bott of the United Church of Canada that might give us some insight and make it a little easier. This prayer has gone viral, is showing up all over the internet. It's called the Mask Prayer. A prayer as I put on my mask. Creator, as I prepare to go into the world, help me see the sacrament and wearing of this cloth. Let it be an outward sign of an inward grace, a tangible and visible way of living love for my neighbors as I love myself. Christ, since my lips will be covered, uncover my heart that people would see my smile and the crinkles around my eyes. My voice may be muffled. Help me to speak clearly, not only with my words, but with my actions. Holy Spirit, as the elastic touches my ears, remind me to listen carefully and full of care to all those I meet. May this simple piece of cloth be shield and banner, and each breath that it holds be filled with your love. In your name, you, the past, the present, and your hopes for the future. And they accept it all. And so I invite you now into a few moments of blessing our friends. And so using a prayer or a blessing that was written many years ago by Mary Carolyn Davies. It's entitled, This is Friendship. So I invite you to just close your eyes, to think about your friends, to see them all around you in a circle perhaps. And just take a deep breath and relax. Holding that image of your friends. And let these words that I speak be your words to each one of them. I love you, not only for what you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you, not only for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the frivolous and weak things that you cannot help seeing there, and drawing out into the light all of the beautiful, radiant things that no one else has looked quite far enough to find. I love you for ignoring the possibilities of the fool in me and for laying firm hold of the possibilities of good in me. I love you for closing your eyes to the discords in me and adding to the music in me by worshipful listening. I love you because you are helping me to make of the lumber of my life not a tavern, but a temple, and of the words of my days not a reproach, but a song. I love you because you have done it more than any creed could have done to make me happy. You have done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. You have done it by being yourself. After all, perhaps this is what being a friend means. And so just let yourself be in the energy of those words and to feel the deep gratitude for each one. Thank them. Thank God for my friends, for they are truly precious blessings to my life. And now we let them go on to the activities of their day, and we bring our attention back to our activities. And we do so with joyful hearts and gratitude for our friends. And because we allow it to be so, so it is. This week, I invite you to do this. Every time you think of your friends, just affirm, "Thank God for my friends." See, just thank God for my friends. It will bless them in ways unknown to you, and it will bless you because you have given your love. So this morning, we have a special opportunity to welcome a couple of new friends. And so I'm going to invite you ladies to come up to the platform, if you will. You come up with it. This morning we have the pleasure of welcoming these two ladies who have recently chosen to become members of Unity of Daytona Beach. Membership is open to everyone who desires to know God more and is willing to study and live to the best of his or her abilities the spiritual principles taught and practiced by Jesus Christ. Charles Fillmore taught there can be only one leader for a person in the search for God, the Spirit within. Unity members, are encouraged to live according to the guidance and instruction of their own indwelling Christ Spirit, without the pressures of dogma or ecclesiastical dictates. Our church exists to provide a place where we minister to each other while pursuing our own individual spiritual growth. We bless and support each other in an atmosphere of love, cooperation, and mutual respect. Our goal is ongoing personal transformation, which translates to ongoing transformation of our spiritual community and ultimately the world. The choice to become a member of Unity of Daytona Beach, then, is an act of commitment to yourself, to all other members and friends of this community, and also to the expansion of good in the world. This is your church, your spiritual home, a place of peace and joy where you know you are loved and welcomed, a place where you belong. You're encouraged to be intimately involved with it, to be an enthusiastic participant. You're asked to consistently pray for your church community and to the best of your ability to generously give it your time, talent, and financial support. You are an important part of this community. You have special gifts to share, which can be given by no one else. Jesus taught you are the light of the world, and I say you are also the light of this church. In just a few moments, I'll invite each of you to receive your membership certificate and a rose presented by Reverend Teresa. The certificate documents your commitment stated here today. The rose is given as a symbol of your beautiful, unfolding spiritual nature. It is also a reminder to all of us to be gentle with each other as we unfold and mature in our spiritual development. For these roses still have their thorns, but if they're handled gently, the thorns cause no injury. In the process of unfolding from within in our church community, no doubt we will discover that we all have at least a few thorns. And so I say, let us handle them gently, our own and those of others. Then there's no injury, and we are all free to enjoy the beauty of each other's blooming Christ nature. As the Minister of Unity of Daytona Beach, it is my joy, on behalf of the congregation and the Board of Trustees, to welcome you into full and active membership in this spiritual community. Nicole Minchell, welcome. And Norma Rizzo. And now I'll invite those of you at home to follow along with the words on the screen, and let's speak our blessing together for these two beautiful souls. The light of Christ shines forth from you. Our light shines brighter through your presence here. We love you. We bless you. We behold the Christ in you. We welcome you into our hearts and this spiritual community. We thank God for you, new friends. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And so whenever we come back to church and you have the opportunity, when it's safe to do so, I hope you will give them both a great big hug. Yes? Okay.
And I never thought I'd feel this way. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm glad I got the chance to say that I do believe I love you.
And if I should ever go away, well then close your eyes and try to feel the way we do today. And then if you can remember, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me, for sure. And that's what friends are for. In good times, in bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. And that's what friends are for. Well, you came and opened me. Now there's so much more I see. And so, by the way, I thank you. And then, for the times when we're apart, well, then close your eyes and know these words are coming from my heart. And then, if you can remember,
keep smiling. Keep shining, knowing you can always count on me, for sure. That's what friends are for. In good times, in bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. That's what friends are for. Keep shining,
keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure, that's what friends are for. In good times and bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. That's what friends are for.
That's what friends are for. I'll be on your side forevermore. Just breathe that in and really know what that means for your life. It's so rich and it's so powerful to live in that energy of knowing how deeply loved you are by the people around you. We all know that. And I hope this morning's been a fresh experience of it for you. During this time, if we were all together, we would be receiving our offertory. And so I know that most of you are giving electronically or by check. And we so appreciate that you have been committed and faithful to supporting your church as we go through this time of being socially distanced from one another. And I know that your heart and your consciousness is that God is source. And so I ask you to continue to hold that consciousness, and most especially as you're making the arrangements to send your check or to give it, however you are giving your gift, please know that God is source, and as you're making those plans, be with us in speaking our affirmation of abundance. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God, and it is so. Join me for a moment as we close our time together with prayer. Precious Spirit, we are so very grateful for this time together. We say thank you for our friends. Thank you for the many blessings that come through our relationships of love with one another. And let us be open to the possibility that those we haven't considered to be friends in the past could become friends now. Let us be open to new friends in the future. Thank you for the giving hearts of this community, the ones that give their time, their talent, their commitment to financial support and to fulfilling the mission and vision of this community. Just say it with me, friends, and feel it in the depths of your soul. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And now join me in speaking our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us wherever we are. God is, and all is well. So now, pretend you're here in the sanctuary with 500 other people. And stretch out your hands, whole hands in spirit, and let's sing our peace song.
Begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God our Creator, we are family. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let
this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Thank you.